Russell and Dave Brown right along ringside, and by golly, we're ready to go with another big championship wrestling, but there is something special, and we'll get to that in just a minute. Dave, what we got coming
all
up?
All right. First of all, let me tell you who's going to be here. We're going to have the King here today. He is going to be going in a single match. Also in a single match today, Iron Mike Sharpe, the big guy out of Canada. Then we'll have the Interns in here. Tag team action. Troy Graham, their manager, will be with them. We will then have, later on today, the Terminators going against Mark and Brad, the Batten Brothers. But before we get to that match, we have something we've never had on TV before, I don't think, and that is a loser-leave TV match. The former Nightmares, Danny Davis and Ken Wayne, will be going against the Daydreamers.
Yeah, it even goes further than that, Dave, but rather than explain it right here, I'm going to wait and explain how what happened with the Eddie Marlin on that particular match a little bit later on in the program. And it cannot go without passing to say that this very day marks the first of what will be at least 52 weeks without Jimmy Hart. All right. Right now, I want to call a guy out here that was responsible for it all. I'm talking about the King. We wanted him in here. Nothing is more fitting. Tremendous match with Gilbert, and I got to tell you, it feels good.
Well, it feels real, real good to me, Lance. I just heard you say 52 weeks without Jimmy Hart.
Minimum.
Minimum, exactly. And believe me, you know, I've gotten asked thousands of times, letters and all kind of requests. People saying, you got Jimmy Hart into wrestling. When are you going to get him out of it? And I think the question has been answered. We don't have to look at Jimmy Hart for at least 52 more weeks around here, and I'm tickled to death. And Lance, it's real good to have this Southern Heavyweight title back in my hand.
Congratulations on that, too. I didn't mean to.
I want to thank once again, because, you know, I said this before, but believe me, in a match like I had with Eddie Gilbert, the fan support means so much, and to have the people there and to have them behind you, I just want to say thank you to all the fans out there who were behind me on this match.
Absolute dynamite tussle, I'll tell you that for a living fact. And we are delighted to see Jerry here and see the belt around his waist and to be able to say the first of 52. Okay, Dave, we got a lot to do right here, so what do you say we get at it? We'll be back with action coming up in the ring in just one moment.
Over 1,000 major price reductions await you at Fleming's fabulous February showcase.
With these great boxes of senior furniture.
A country bedroom for $499. Save $600 on this dining room suit at $999. This majestic oak bedroom for $699. A $500 oak computer desk now $277.
Special presidential terms in all Fleming furniture and appliances.
Pay not a Lincoln penny down or a Washington dollar in interest of payments till May of 85 at all Fleming stores, where everything in the store is reduced.
Except my daddy.
Smell those fresh roasted peanuts.
Oh, nothing can penetrate this stuffy nose.
Oh, this can.
Hall's Betholiptus?
Uh-huh. With vapor action. Hall's vapor action has the power to penetrate deep into clogged nasal passages to help your stuffy nose feel clearer, while Hall soothes your throat to help you cough.
Hey, that's great.
The peanuts?
No, the Hall's.
Oh.
For penetrating relief, get Hall's vapor action. And try sugar-free Hall's, too.
John Ellis Chevrolet is chopping prices on all new and used cars and trucks for a red, white, and blue patriotic President's sale in February. You'll find real honest values on every car and truck. Caprices, Celebrities, Cavaliers, Camaros, C10s, F10s, custom vans, used cars and trucks, nothing held back. We've chopped prices on all of them. Every penny you save would make President Abe happy. I'm sure he would say, by George, it just makes good sense to save dollars. So take off for John Ellis Chevrolet and land your best deal.
When you've got a headstrong boss, sometimes you need some headstrong relief. Goodies Extra Strength Tablets.
When you've got a headstrong teenage daughter, sometimes you need some headstrong relief. Goodies Extra Strength Tablets.
No matter what you've tried for a headache, try Goodies Extra Strength Tablets with aspirin and acetaminophen, the two pain relievers doctors recommend most.
What a relief.
Headstrong relief.
Goodies Extra Strength Tablets for real headstrong relief.
Okay, we mentioned a little bit ago we had the big smile because of Hart not being here to make our life miserable. The match that took place between Lawler and Gilbert was not only to determine whether Lawler got out or Hart got out, it was to determine the Southern Heavyweight title. Mm-hmm. I want to tell you, it was 28 minutes and 28 seconds of mayhem. Boy, these guys went at it hard. We're going to show you about 9 minutes of it, but I got to tell you, due to the weather, of course, we did not have our usual crowd down to the Coliseum for the wrestling, and I'm sorry you weren't there. It was sensational. You'll get a flavor of it when you see this. Now, in addition to that, I want you to pay attention to a guy that's around ringside. We'll have some comments about that. Right now, let's look. The King and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert going at it in this match in highlights. In the event that Lawler wins and regains the Southern Heavyweight title, Jimmy Hart will leave the territory for 1 year, will make no attempt to return under a mask or any other way. And by the same token, if Gilbert retains the title, Jerry Lawler has agreed he will leave his hometown and will not return or make an attempt within 1 year. The big surprise, whoa, the flying press put Lawler down, two, and he kicked out. He almost had him. But boy, oh boy, it's hard to believe, but you're looking at it right here, right now. And Gilbert firing away, nailing Lawler hard. Lawler right back, going for a pile driver. He drove him down. Gilbert escapes, gets out of the ring. If he hadn't have gotten out of the ring when he did, Lawler would have it over with right now. Whoa, boy, look at Gilbert. Jerry catches him with a foot as he came in. Pounds ahead of Eddie Gilbert on that top turnbuckle. Gilbert down into the timer's table. His manager right over with him trying to help him back up to the ring. That may do it. Gilbert rolling under the ropes. Boy, I'll tell you, what a lot of savvy this young fella has picked up in the short time he's been a pro wrestler. Over the top rope. Lawler put him on the floor. Suplex. Lawler pounds Gilbert to the mat. Covers him up. One, two, but he gets out of there before the two count got cold. Eddie Gilbert, who has publicly proclaimed the fact that he is the new king. All of his life, he's dreamed of taking Lawler's place. As he said, as Lawler, uh-oh, there's that cane. He grabbed that cane, jammed it in Lawler's midsection, broke it over his back. Two, and Lawler saves it with a... Whoa, he pounded him hard. Gilbert coming off. Lawler's down, two, and just barely saved himself. Lawler with his shoulders flat on the canvas. Gilbert trying to finish him off. Comes down with both feet right in the midsection. He was on a second turnbuckle. Buried him in the midsection with both feet. Eddie Gilbert going for the suplex. Pops Lawler down. Final one, two. Bulldog by Gilbert. He really drove him into the canvas. And Lawler moves that left shoulder up. Gilbert shows signs of weariness. He's having trouble holding Lawler down. Lawler pounded down, and once again, Gilbert grabs part of that broken cane. Tommy up on the ring apron, and Gilbert jabs Lawler right in the throat with it. And Eddie stinging Lawler hard. Boy, he really put him down. Woo! Lawler just keeps coming back up after him. Eddie Gilbert stomping Lawler's head. In the air, body slam. Gilbert goes to the second rope. Flies down over Lawler for another. He got a two count, and that's all. Pulls the table up, brings Lawler out of the ring, and slams Jerry Wild right into that table. Gilbert's pulled it all out. He grabs a mic stand. They're out here on the floor. Gilbert's tried everything, but he hadn't been able to get a pin on him. Referee running Tommy H, the lookalike. Jerry still under his own power. With the table on Lawler, Gilbert jumps on top of it. 21 minutes in. Jerry back to his feet. There's that strap of Lawler snapped down, and he really tags Gilbert hard. Jerry, a good running start, nails him again, but stumbles into the ropes. Swings so hard he loses his own balance. Lawler again puts Gilbert down, staggers around the ring. Lawler going for a pile driver, got low bridged by Eddie Gilbert. Lawler down, Gilbert down. Gilbert's glassy-eyed almost. Eddie Gilbert staggering to the turnbuckles. He's going to try to finish Lawler off. Jerry coming up off the floor, nails Gilbert. Climbs up on the rope with him. From the second rope. Gilbert down, prostrate. Lawler going to the turnbuckles. Tommy H trips him off that top rope. Lawler down. 27 minutes, right at the 28-minute mark. They're both stretched out. Gilbert turning it over. He's on his knee. Goes down. Gilbert falls across him. his shoulders are down. Two. He rolls Gilbert up. Two, three, got it. Jimmy Hart is gone. And 28 seconds and one that will not be forgotten. It'll go down in history. Jerry Lawler not only regains the Southern belt but sends Jimmy Hart packing for 1 year.
What a classic moment that was, and I want to make a couple of comments. One of them, if you saw a guy there that looked like Jimmy Hart, he was there. Tommy H is the way Eddie Gilbert introduced him in there, and he was out and looked so much like Hart, I couldn't believe it. I thought at first that Hart had violated the rules and come back, Jerry.
Well, you know, Hart said that we were in store for a big shock, and that was quite a shock. Yeah. This guy looked like a clone or something. I mean, he was
like an
identical twin to Jimmy Hart. You know, I mean, as you said, a match 28 minutes long. Eddie Gilbert knew that there was a lot at stake in that match, and he gave it everything he had. I feel like I had some of the other wrestlers watching back there said that that was Eddie Gilbert's finest match. You know, I mean, when you're in a match like that, that brings out the best in you. He shot his best shot, but he came up a little bit short, Lance, and now Jimmy Hart's gone. But Eddie Gilbert was the holder of the Southern title up
True.
Until that match came about. And in the contract for that match, it stated that he would get an immediate rematch.
A rematch if he lost it.
That's right. Well, Eddie Gilbert does get a rematch, and that's going to come up Sunday, tomorrow afternoon, as a matter of fact. And if you think there was a lot riding on last week's match, there's even more riding on this week's match, because we find out on Friday after this match was signed, Eddie Marlin calls me, and you know, I told you last week that Eddie Marlin had been calling the different champions, the different organizations, trying to get a title match secured for the Memphis area, but because of the success I'd had against him in the past, was unable to do so. Well, after the match was signed for me and Eddie on a return, Eddie Marlin calls and says, the winner of this match will get a world heavyweight title match, because he just got the contract signed that the AWA heavyweight champion Rick Martel would come here next week and defend against the Southern heavyweight champion.
So it will take place regardless of who wins the match tomorrow afternoon. The World Heavyweight title match, Rick Martel, his first defense in Memphis, and I think it's great that Eddie was able to get him in here.
Well, that's why this belt, Lance, is so important, because, as I said, he's not coming here to wrestle Jerry Lawler, and he's not coming here to wrestle Eddie Gilbert. The World Heavyweight champion is coming to Memphis to wrestle the Southern Heavyweight champion. And so, as I said, Eddie Gilbert held his belt up until last week, and now we're going to have to go in because of a return clause in the contract. So whoever comes out of that match tomorrow afternoon with this belt is going to get a shot the following week at the World Heavyweight Championship now, Lance. And as I said, everybody out here knows, you know, how long I've chased this title, and they know what the world title means to me. But it's something that they may be underestimating, and something that I'm certainly thinking about, is how much it would mean to a guy like Eddie Gilbert. Yeah. Now, you saw how hard he fought last week, and all he had at stake was trying to keep Jimmy Hart in the area. But now Eddie Gilbert is going to be fighting for Eddie Gilbert. He's going to be fighting for himself a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship. And I realize that I'm not the only wrestler that wants to be the world champion. I know it's in the back of every wrestler's mind. It's the dream of every wrestler that ever puts on a pair of tights to be the World Heavyweight Champion. I'm no exception. And I know that Eddie Gilbert wants to be the champion just as bad as I do. Well, I will tell you this, Eddie Gilbert. You got a long road to hoe, brother, because I've been waiting for this for a long, long time. And tomorrow afternoon at that Mid-South Coliseum, the man that gets his hand raised at the end of that match is going to wear this belt, and he's the one that's going to get the world title shot. Now, you bring that little Jimmy Hart lookalike down there. You have him running around the ring if you want to, because there's something that he hadn't experienced that Hart did experience.
I know
that's a fractured leg, and that's a broken jaw, and that's getting that face and that hair burned off. And all of those things are ahead for this little Jimmy Hart lookalike. And I think that we can change his mind about wanting to be in professional wrestling in one afternoon, brother. I can guarantee you that. So, Eddie Gilbert, all I can say is you had a heck of a match against me last week. And if you want to wear this belt, you're going to have a better one tomorrow night. And I don't think you got a better one in you, brother.
Okay, Jerry, tomorrow afternoon we'll be looking forward to that action. I don't have to tell you. You've already said it. He was a tremendous competitor in that bout in there, and when he's going for something that a young fella that has a chance for the future that he does, you better believe it will be a duplicate and even more so tomorrow afternoon at the Coliseum, 3 o'clock. Let's go to the ring. We're ready for the next match. Dave.
One fall, 10-minute time limit match coming up here. Jerry Bryant stepping into the ring right now. Jerry at 218 pounds out of Memphis, Tennessee, going against, from Memphis, at 234 pounds, the King, Jerry Lawler. This is going to be one fall, 10-minute time limit match. The referee, Jerry Calhoun. Lawler with that Southern heavyweight belt in the ring with him today. It is a non-title match.
Jerry really happy to have that back around his waist, I can tell you. Bell time.
Bryant backing away. Bryant, we wouldn't describe him as a young wrestler. Bryant is a wrestler who started out very young, wrestled for several years, and he went into other things for a few years, and now he's back wrestling again, challenging the best here in the King.
Yeah, with a little bit different attitude than he previously had. He felt like he should have made better progress, wasn't treated exactly as fair, wasn't given as good of partners as maybe he thought that he deserved. He couldn't get certain guys to wrestle with him as a partner, and so Jerry's attitude has not been exactly the same as it was when we first knew it.
He just bounced across the ring there. Immediately he jumped to his feet and he started yelling. He had his hair pulled. Crowd reaffirming that Lawler did not pull hair. Bryant again goes flying across the ring. Lawler simply using the arm. He just took him across the ring about a quarter of the way, and Bryant, unable to, I suppose, explain it to himself otherwise, just yells hair pulling again. Bryant back in the King into a corner. Referee calling for the break. Bryant breaks it with a right fist. Boy, how many times have we seen that happen to the King over the years, and he'll pay for it. If not in this match, some other time.
Yeah, that's the starter right there. That'll get his attention, and Lawler out. Head in the head with Bryant.
Back in the corner, Lawler. Bryant again using the right fist. Bryant, evil little smile on his face, tells the referee he had his hand open. Mm-hmm. Puts him on the mat, says, hey, you want to use the fist? Then I ought to use the two. Bryant out of the ring now, down on the floor here. He's going to take advantage of the 10 count, at least a portion of it, to get back into the action. Referee's telling him, come on back in here, and the count does start. Bryant up on the apron, through the rope. 2 minutes, 45 seconds gone in this one. 10 minutes, our overall time limit. Boy, still to come today. We've got all kinds of wrestling action.
Really waiting for also that fascinating match between the Daydreamers and the Nightmares, Wayne and Davis. We'll have more to say about that, but that's yet to come.
Bryant hanging back in the corner now after being bounced around the ring by Lawler. I think referee Jerry Calhoun was probably telling both of them, all right, no hair, no fist, let's just have a wrestling match. Bryant backed into a corner. Lawler takes him out of there nicely, beeled him all the way across the ring. Yeah, Bryant going to the tights.
Crowd hollering at Jerry as he takes a shot to the midsection, and Bryant nails him with whatever he had in his hand. It's now safely tucked back in the tights. He picks Lawler up.
slams him with a very solid right hand. Lawler back on his feet again. Bryant jerks that 234 pounds straight up. Drops with the elbow. Jerry Bryant with a run going against Lawler right here.
Nailing him again with that right hand. Putting Bryant, oh, look out. That comes down. Mr. Bryant may be in trouble here. He was. Lawler rams that head into the top turnbuckle. Bryant into the rope. Good morning, or
you
good night.
You can't believe how solid that is, too, boy. Lawler is a whale of a lot more solid than he looks like, I'm going to tell you.
Look out,
what is this? Eddie Gilbert.
Eddie Gilbert in combat clothes, jumps in the ring.
Playboy Frazier right behind him. Got all those fatigues on and the helmet and kicks Lawler out on the floor with the help of friends as Gilbert and Frazier come in. It cost Bryant the match by disqualification on their interference. But even more than that, Eddie was able to get in some cheap shots on Lawler. Winner by disqualification. What was the time, Dave?
Time on it was 5 minutes, 6 seconds.
5:00. We got 5:06, and the winner was Jerry Lawler by disqualification. We're going to take time out. We'll be back in just a moment.
During Central Appliance and TV Rentals grand opening, you can win TVs, stereos, trips, free rentals, 25,000 quality stamps. We'll give you 100 for paying on time, 100 just for asking. Tell them, Johnny.
Look, nobody can beat our prices. Are you renting or thinking about renting from someone else? We're the first in Memphis, we're still the lowest. We will save you money. You'll get it easy, you'll get it today, you'll get it for less. I personally guarantee it.
Poncho's quality means something good. For a full-course Mexican dinner, a quick and tasty lunch, or those unmatchable chips and dips, Poncho's quality means crisp and fresh and delicious. Because we carefully watch everything that says Poncho's. Restaurants, fast food outlets, and supermarket products meet the same high standards. For lunch, dinner, parties, or private snacks, enjoy the tasty, crunchy, scrumptious quality of Poncho's. Because Poncho's means something good.
We got the drive, we're on the beam, we're the winners, we got team, truck team. Listen to this, your GMC truck team dealers will sell you this full-size pickup truck equipped with special option package at a good price. And air conditioning comes along with it at no extra charge. One reason why more people are buying GMC trucks than any time in history. A good truck, a good value, and air conditioning at no extra charge at Foster, Mary, Pryor, Hudson, Rook, and General Truck, your GMC truck team, son.
Don't take it out on your battery. Tune up for fast starts at Expert Tune. Your engine is computer analyzed and expertly tuned by certified mechanics you can talk to. A 30-minute guaranteed tune-up at Expert Tune costs less than a new battery. Expert Tune. For starters.
Okay, we're going to be ready to go with our next bout, which will be Iron Mike Sharpe coming up in just a moment. And we've got a couple of tag matches I know you don't want to miss. Here comes right now the hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert. And I see you have. First, I want to ask you, we noticed when you interfered in that match, all this army get up in there. What in the Sam Hill does this all represent?
Okay, Lance, one thing at a time, please, okay? First of all, as we all know, Jimmy Hart's gone, right?
Well, he's gone. You got that right. 52 weeks of being gone.
That's right. So that means the First Family is no more in professional wrestling. So what I've done now, I've gone out And from now on, when you address me as General Eddie Hot Stuff Gilbert. And what I'm going to do, baby, is I'm starting the most dominant force of professional wrestling, and it's going to be called Eddie's Army. And yours truly, it just happens to be the head of it, Lance. And see, our mission, our goal, our cause is to eliminate the dirt and the filth from professional wrestling, just like Jerry Lawler, handsome Jimmy Valiant, the fabulous one, and so on and so on. And we're not going to stop until it happens. You see, I'm taking applications because, gentlemen, everybody listening, all wrestlers listening, Eddie's Army needs you.
Well, okay, we see you've got all the trappings. The trappings do not make a general, I might add that. All right, let's get on to the next thing. Who do we have standing right here that looks dead ringer for Jimmy Hart?
Lance, I think he can talk for himself.
Baby, my name's Tommy. You can call me T.H., but let me tell you something else, Russell. Why don't you just call me T.H. Hart? That's what I want to be called from now on. Yeah, that's right. Well, look at here. I've been a big fan, you know, of Jimmy Hart. I've been an idol. He's been my idol, you know. Well, I've been looking up since I was just a little kid. Well, let me tell you something. Jimmy Hart's not here. Well,
that's right.
That's right.
Won't be.
That's right. And what do you do with a horse when you can't use him anymore? You shoot him. Well, Jimmy Hart's gone. And see, since I've looked up here, I've learned to look like him, act like him, dress like him. That's right. And now I'm going to join forces with Eddie Gilbert, and we're going to get up there, and we'll get rid of the man to send him out to start with.
Well, I hope you know what you're doing,
that's
friend.
Right. In the words of a great man, I want to tell you, this is the greatest day of my life.
Isn't it great? Dave.
Isn't it great? Mm. So, Lance, back to the Army here. See, this week, a young man approached me, and you just saw him in the ring here. A young man approached me that showed a little interest in being in the Army. So I took it into account, and I'd like to get Jerry Bryant out here right now because I've got a lot of goals set for him. Jerry Bryant?
Well, Eddie, I hope we're not in for one of these long, drawn-out, this-is-your-life Jerry Bryant-type things in here. We've had these dissertations from you before. Yeah, you just cost him the match, by the way. For a fact, he got disqualified in that bout that they just saw.
You know, Jerry, come here. I got to talk to you here. I want everybody to listen to this. Now, you realize, to be in Eddie's Army, you got to show a lot of loyalty, dedication, and want to ability and drive, right?
Right. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you really want to be in the Army, don't you? I know. I can just tell by your eyes. So what I've done now, I figure for you to show all that loyalty and dedication, well, I think you just need to show it. I'll tell you what. You hold on to this just a second. See if I can get a chair here. Tommy, can you see if we can get an extension cord here just a second? Let me get a chair.
Jerry, I got to tell you, I hope you know what you're doing, too.
Now, Lance,
you're getting involved with some bad news.
Just have a seat, Jerry. Let me see. In any Army or whatever that you join, you know, you always, when you start, you got to start with a GI haircut.
Oh, no. Did you hear that?
See, Jerry, any Army, you got to go through to show your dedication and loyalty to me and the Army. We got to see if we can get a GI haircut here. And see, you should also feel greatly honored that Eddie Gilbert is about to cut your hair.
Okay, that's the first thing he's going to cut. The neck will probably be your purse of anything that you get in there, too. Are you sure you're willing for this?
Yes, I want to be in the Army, that's
right.
Okay?
That's right.
Get a haircut.
Yeah, where should I just start here?
Hold it. I want to be in the Army. You shut up. I want to be in the Army.
Playboy Frazier.
I want to be in the Army. I want to be the first lieutenant. I'm the man. I want to be your bodyguard. I want to be in. Get up.
Playboy.
Shut up, pig face. Let this man do the talking, General. Look at this loyalty and dedication.
That's right. Me. Cut my hair.
I got another word for it. We'll keep it to myself right now.
Here, right?
Yeah, but don't get it near me.
Come on,
I can't believe this is really happening. You know you're voluntarily sitting here. He's going to cut all your hair off, Frazier. You understand that?
I understand that. You don't worry about it, pig face.
Well, there it goes. Take a good look at it, friend.
Go on, ask what you wish. You get your hair cut, baby.
You're really taking a charge out of this, aren't you?
Army wants you. The Army needs you.
Right.
Eddie's Army. We're not stopping. The Fabulous One, Jerry Lawler, Jimmy Valiant. Look at this dedication from Playboy Frazier. This is what I want in my Army. I want dedication. This man will be a champion. This man will be a superstar. Look at this.
This man will be bald. That's what it is.
Yeah. Isn't it great? Look at this. See, Bryant? See the prize, but think of the... Yes. Here, turn your head a little bit here. I know a lot of these fat guys sitting at home now watching this wish they could sit right where Frazier's sitting. Wish they could be in the Army.
You wish.
Yes, sir.
Get it all off the top, too.
Next thing you know, Jerry Lawler will be coming out here sitting down saying, oh, Eddie, I always knew you were the greatest. You were the best. I want to sit where Frazier's sitting. Oh, thank Frazier.
I want to see you go hold your breath until that happens, friend.
You don't worry about it. If you take that wig off, you won't even have no hair.
Yeah. Lance, next thing you know, you'll be joining the Army.
Yeah.
You'll be sitting here. And Dave, yes. Look at this.
Yeah, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll make a deal with you. I'll be right after Lawler.
Lawler will be out here for about 2 weeks. Please cut my hair.
That's right. Okay.
Are you believing what you're seeing? This guy voluntarily sits down in a chair. You turn around. You fight for your life and your hair against the Battens in a match, and now you're...
First lieutenant of my Army, Playboy Frazier, and Private... Private Bryant. Now, also, what a great day this is. Oh, right here's another man I've been
talking. I'm proud to be in the Army. I'm proud. Well, I salute you, right?
Mike Sharpe, go in there and show them Army material and show them what we're going to do to
people. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And Valiant and the Fabulous
That's
One.
Right.
Lance, it's been your pleasure, I'm sure.
I can't tell you how impressed I've been with an absolute... ignorance that has been displayed. He sat down and said, cut it. And he did. Okay, Dave.
All right. We're ready for a one fall, 10-minute time limit match from Memphis, Tennessee, at 216-pound Jim Jameson going against from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, 275-pound Iron Mike Sharpe. One fall, 10-minute time limit match. Jerry Calhoun, the referee, and...
Dave, see, not everybody can be in the Army. Just people like Mike Sharpe, Frazier, Jerry Bryant. You've got to prove yourself. Dedication.
Well, what are all of you still doing out here hanging around a ring?
This is a great day for us. We're going to go through all these people like Sherman went through Atlanta, Lance.
Mike Sharpe grabs Jameson and gets him before he ever even gets the shirt off his back in there. Slams his head into a turnbuckle.
You thought Jimmy Hart was bad. Well, you ain't seen nothing yet, baby.
Yeah. Oh, Dave.
Look out, Jameson thrown through the rope. Hey, you got, that's Tommy H or T.H. or look out.
Come on, hey, come on, Rush. Get this guy out of here. He's got no business out here anyhow. Over here pounding on Jameson. He just got thrown over our desk. Eddie Gilbert out with that crop beating on him. Sharpe gets him back in the ring and... continues the slaughter of Jim Jameson. There's that big arm with that big brace. One, two, three.
Minute 19, the time on it.
Well, Sharpe may have changed from the First Family to the Army. But he still used the same tactics he used him on Jameson. He beat him around, jumped him before it ever got started, whipped him into the rope, and watch this with that arm. Hit him right there with that big brace that Sharpe has on his arm and put Jim Jameson away, Dave.
That was at a minute 19 the time.
Minute and 19 seconds, the winner, Iron Mike Sharpe. We've got some more of it. We'll be looking at the Fabulous Ones coming up in just a moment.
You can save up to 50% on quality furniture this Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at Unpainted Furniture Center's Big Truckload Sale. For 3 days only, take advantage of wholesale prices on oak tables, china cabinets, roll-top desks, and chairs of all kinds. Buy this quality furniture completely finished at wholesale prices, or save even more and finish it yourself. Unpainted Furniture Center's Big Truckload Sale, 3556 Mendenhall Road South, Thursday and Friday, 3526 Jackson all day Saturday. Don't miss it.
A good time to shop for a mid-size car is just after dark, when it's still light enough to make out the shape, but not the name. Because that's about all that separates the Chevy Celebrity from a Buick Century or old Sierra, except the price. Celebrity costs $1,200 less than a Sierra and $1,300 less than a Century. Now that you've seen the light, see your Memphis area Chevy dealers. Isn't it great to love a car you can afford?
Until now, effective cough relief usually came in a spoon. Now, Mediquel announces the end of the spoon. New Mediquel Chewy Cough Squares for cough relief so strong it lasts 8 hours long. Mediquel took a powerful liquid cough medicine and concentrated it into soft, chewy squares. Each dose relieves coughs up to 8 hours, twice as long as regular strength liquids. The end of the spoon. New Mediquel Chewy Cough Squares. Cough relief so strong it lasts 8 hours long.
Hand warming, hot hand warming.
Put your hands together on the hot Big Mac.
Hot, hot, oh, that hot fish fry.
Don't it warm your hands, make you want to clap.
Filet and fish, a hot, hot dish.
It's a good time for the great taste.
Big Mac, pork belly, french fries, chicken, 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 McNuggets. Hand warming.
It's a good time for the great taste. McDonald's.
It's hand warming time in the sun.
Stan and Steve, by golly, I'll tell you what, they are some fabulous ones, too. Let's take a look at them right now. Camera magic there with Stan and Steve, the fabulous ones. They perform their own brand of magic when they get inside that ring. Boy, they are really looking good, too, and looking great shape as always. There are a couple of guys that I like one thing about them. They are dedicated to their profession. They stay in a gym and keep in shape. By golly, I'll tell you. It's interesting, too. We haven't heard from him in a long time. Personally, what do you say we take a listen right now to the guy that's responsible for the fabulous ones, Jackie Fargo.
Hello, it's certainly a pleasure to come into your homes again and have a chance to have a word with the fans, as I've done over the years. It's always a pleasure. I think you probably remember a couple years ago, I sat probably in the same spot here telling you about two of the greatest wrestlers that I'd seen since probably Donnie and myself, and they're the Fabs. Well, I seen something in these two guys that you don't see. You do things to your expectation. They went out there and wrestled not only to my or their expectation, but they reached way beyond, and that really was amazing for me because I thought I was the only guy that ever did that. And when I seen my two fabs, I seen something in me that I really liked, and boy, it was great. And they had to get their little feel. They had to go to New York, and they had to go to Minnesota, and they had to go to Hawaii, and they had to go all over. But they're not going to tell me, and they're not going to tell you that they're not glad to be back in the good old South, baby, because there's no place like the good old South. I love these two boys, and let me tell you something. I think you might have heard this over the years, often imitated but never duplicated. Well, I think that's a proven fact. Two of the greatest wrestlers and two of the finest young men I've ever known, and I'm very pleased to say that I do know them and that I'm associated with them. And like I told you before, they don't have a heart like a peanut. They got a heart like a watermelon. I think a hell of a lot of these two boys. Always will. I was on vacation over in Nassau, and I got a phone call. I didn't say why, what, or where. Because any time I told them to go wrestle, they didn't ask me when, what, or where, or how, or I can't, or I won't was not in their vocabulary. And I didn't ask any questions. I came home, and when I met them, yeah, two grown men had tears in their eyes, and my heart was broken. I knew something bad was wrong. And they showed me a film of what happened with their fathers. Two fine men, and I'm telling you, I know because I played golf with both of them, visited both of them. And I've never seen two men prouder of the boys than they are. And they got a damn good right to be. You should be proud of two boys like this. If you can believe it, I'm lost for words, and that's hard for me to comprehend. I can get lost for words. Just think, I want you to stop and put yourself in this position. I want you to project yourself into Steve and Stan, and let it be your father. Well, I didn't have to. I knew. I looked back and seen and said, what if it had been yours and Don or Roughhouse's dad? I knew what I'd have done, Troy. You stinking punk, you low-down rat. You think you've been in a fight? I told him to do with you what you do with a rattlesnake. Show that you can control him, grab him by the neck. And let him go and play with him and grab him again and let him go. Do you understand where I'm coming from, men that did this? Do you understand me? Do you get what I'm saying? No, I don't want to take a pistol and shoot you. I don't want them to smack you around. I want them to punish you. They got hurt right in there. They're hurting bad. Well, I've sat down and I've talked with them. You can't calm them down. I don't want them to calm down. I don't want to calm them down at all. Ladies and gentlemen, you're in for a furious battle. If you don't know what I'm saying or what I'm trying to bleed out for my boys, I'm just saying that this, if it ever happens to you, then you'll know what I mean. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure, and I'll see you. I'll be around with the boys, and so long, everybody.
Fabulous one, Jackie Fargo. And now we're ready to hit that ring up there, and the object of the attention of not only Jackie, but also the Fab. I hear you talk. Okay, we've got set for the match, Dave. Let's go ahead and go with the introduction.
All right, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Total weight, 456 pounds on the right from Memphis, Tennessee, both of them. David Haskins and his partner, Ken Raper, going against them at 590 pounds from parts unknown with their manager, Troy Graham, the intern. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
Okay, bell time, and here we go. The intern number two will be starting out against David Haskins in this match.
5 years older than water, man. That was Frank Keirn from last time.
We heard it, Troy. You make your comments about Fargo and the Fabs and all you want to. With no respect, I can tell you that, for what you guys did to their father. Big elbow drop down, and the intern number one takes over on David Haskins. There's a tag, and intern number two in there to cooperate on a double backdrop. Big knee pops down on Haskins. Haskins and Rape are physically a good-looking team, Dave.
Yeah, they both have good size, but still, they're giving away tons when you're considering that both of these interns weigh about 300 pounds. They're coming about 300 each.
There's the tag, and Ken Rape will make his first appearance in against the intern number one. And he went at him, faked him high, put the foot low, and banged him down on the back of the neck. And he's got Raper down, middle of the ring, tosses him right outside on the floor. Troy Graham coming over there by him as the referee, keeping the intern back. And Graham takes a cheap shot at him out here. Referee hollering at him to get back in the corner and stay away from him. He's now jumping down toward the action, but the intern rolls Raper back in the ring. Big backdrop, boy, oh boy. Raper way up high. Ken a big one, too. But as Dave pointed out, big is relative, I guess, and compared to the guys he's in there with, he's taller, but nowhere near as heavy. I see him, Troy. Impressed. Over the top with a big splash. He catapulted him over the top, and that'll be a 1-2-3. It is over. Nifty maneuver between the interns. I got to give them credit for that. It's interesting how they use the rope to catapult the intern number one over that top rope. First, there's a big slam of Haskins, or rather of Raper down there. And now with the rope, you see him. Boy, that is a 300-pound missile flying over there, squashing him right there in the middle of the ring. And the winner is the intern. And what kind of time, Dave?
2 minutes, 3 seconds.
2:03. We'll be back with more in just a moment.
Which size garden harvest would you rather have? Hi, I'm Dean Leaf, and I have exciting news for vegetable gardeners everywhere. With Troy-Bilt's new wide-row growing method, you can nearly triple your harvest, even in a small garden.
Use the Troy-Bilt for preparing super-rich soil. The unique design with tines in the rear and power-driven wheels lets it till deep while you guide it with just one hand. It chops up and turns under all kinds of organic matter to build the fertile soil vegetable plants thrive in, and then it prepares beautiful seed beds for planting the wide row way.
So if you want to harvest like this instead of this, build super rich soil with your own Troy-Bilt tiller and start growing vegetables the wide row way.
Special off-season savings are in effect now on all Troy-Bilt tiller models and attachments. So write or call for information and your free Troy-Bilt catalog. Call toll-free 1-800-453-9000. That's 1-800-453-9000 right now. Operators are standing by.
I'm Honeymoon Garner, Mr. TV Rentals. This is our phone number. This is a rentable TV. Rent it weekly, monthly, or whatever. No credit check, free same-day delivery. And listen, we rent all these other things, too. Stereos, washers, dryers, VCRs, fridges, microwaves. Hey, call this number now. I'm Honeymoon Garner, Mr. TV Rentals. Oh, that's probably you now.
You'll be the leader of the pack in a Pontiac. A Pontiac from the Pontiac Pack.
The pack is back with the Pontiac Sunbird. The practical car packed with performance capabilities and exceptional styling. Two-door, four-door, and wagons. Three smart choices for a lot of driving fun. And right now, the smartest thing you can do is check with your Pontiac Pack dealers and discover Sunbird value and excitement. It's the Pontiac Sunbird at Pat Carter, Foster, and Courtesy.
Pontiac Pack.
Shut up, big lip.
There they are, the Southern Tag Champs, the Interns with Troy Graham.
Too sweet, baby. Sunday evening, 3 o'clock, no time limit, no disqualification. 24 hours from now, baby, then what kind of excuse are you going to have when we walk away, baby? Jackie Fargo out here, he's 5 years old in water. There ain't nothing holding him up but varicose veins. We got the belt, and we're going to remain the champion belt, baby, if you understand what I'm saying. If you got any kind of film you want to show, you've always got some kind of...
Yeah, I would like to.
Read the book, man. Are you asleep or what?
Troy, will you let me introduce this one? This is a situation where Stan Lane was snowed in, unable to get to the...
He was snowed in, baby. He was snowed in. He was scared to make it. That's what was wrong. He
wasn't scared to make it, but Steve Keirn wasn't afraid to get in there and scrap it. Let's take a look at this right here. Keirn rips the intern. Here's the other intern. It'll be a disqualification as a second intern. Comes in. He's got a pair of handcuffs. Disqualification, the winner will be Keirn in 4 minutes. Troy Graham hollering. Handcuff him, beat him up. Keirn trying to fight his way out of it. And the intern slams into his partner as Keirn ducks. Now he's got the handcuffs. Handcuffs that the interns brought in. He handcuffs them. Here come the Terminators. Keirn grabs the chain he had, but the interns chained together have the Terminators helping them. Here's the Dirty White Boys. The interns scoot out of here. The Dirty White Boys have got the Terminators on the run. And Keirn is the winner in 4 minutes. Well, he had his hand raised.
Yeah, but baby, he had a foreign object. We packed no star, Coach Wonder Far, for the only law was a hook and a draw. We're Panthers quick and leather tough, because we figured if we've been pushed enough, we have a dream we'll hold to our dying breath. We'll search for our soul and gamble with death. No time limit, no disqualification. Sunday evening, Memphis, Tennessee, baby. What kind of excuse are you going to have when we leave there and walk out with these belts in? What kind of film will you show then, Stan and Steve? What kind of film will you show then? I guess you'll want to bring old fat Jackie Fargo in, and we'll drop him just like we dropped your old fat daddy, baby. Rare it up. 3 o'clock, Memphis, Tennessee.
Okay.
Sunday evening, baby.
Yeah, we're going to tell them about when it is. Troy Graham and the interns, and they, of course, will be in action down at the Mid-South Coliseum tomorrow afternoon. 3 o'clock is the bell time on there. Before I get into the entire card, I would like to make a quick comment about the wrestling hotline. The wrestling hotline mechanism machine has been a little ill, but it is now back going in full force in there. We want to thank our good friends up at the Eastgate Shopping Center Radio Shack right off of Park Avenue for their help in getting us back into action here with the hotline. So now you call. It may be busy because we get a lot of calls in there, but remember 685-6969, and we try to keep you up to date on the latest wrestling information, who's going to be on the card, who the winners were, and so forth and so on. Okay, 685-6969. Now let's take a look specifically at the action coming up. Going to be a beautiful day today. We don't have Dave right here with us, but it is already forecast. We were talking to him about it. Really a pretty day for you to come and make that visit from wherever you may be. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon, it'll be at the Mid-South Coliseum. Ticket prices 4, 5, and 6. Children 10 and under admitted to general admission for $1. So you make it a point to be right out there with us. Opening bout is going to be Tojo Yamamoto going against Jerry Bryant. The Nightmares, Ken Wayne and Danny Davis, will be joined by Mr. Wrestling and Joe Lightfoot to go in an 8-man tag match. And this one is going to be the Daydreamers and Mark and Brad Batten. We've got something up coming a little bit later that may have bearing on that match, on a match here today. We'll get to that in a little bit. Mixed ladies and man's tag match. Playboy Frazier, without hair, will be joined by Von Hoffman. Linda Von Hoffman, I believe it is. Lanny Poffo will be joined by Candy Devine in that mixed ladies and man's tag match. A no time, no disqualification match. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, will be going against the exotic Adrian Street with Miss Linda at ringside. We'll be hearing from Savage later. Mid-America title match. Handsome Jimmy, the new Mid-America champion, will be defending against the former champ, Iron Mike Sharpe. Going to be a lot of irritation coming out in that match. And then a loser-leave-town match. These guys just want to get it down and get it over with. The Dirty White Boys, who ended up dumping some flour all over the Terminators last week, will be going against the Terminators in that loser-leave-town. Then a really big one, a Southern heavyweight title match with the winner to get a shot at the world title. Eddie.
The Army begins tomorrow the Mid-South Coliseum at 3 o'clock. Now, Lawler, you came out here and you told all these people that Eddie Gilbert gave you your best shot, brother. Well, I ain't ever give you my best shot, and I promise you and all these stinking people one thing. You're never going to get a world title shot. You're going to have to retire, brother.
Well, we'll find that out. That's why the match is. Somebody is going to have the Southern heavyweight title, and Eddie Marlin has already arranged for the world champ to face the Southern heavyweight champ. Big significance on the bout tomorrow with Lawler and Gilbert. And then the final match, oh boy, wait till Stan and Steve get it there. Both of them will be there. The Southern tag titles will be at stake. The interns will be defending them. That'll be a most interesting afternoon of action. 3 o'clock is the time. We're looking forward to it, Yandy.
Just want to confirm what you said. For the first time in several weeks, driving conditions will be perfect. Be a great afternoon after all the snow and ice gone. Great tomorrow to drive on out there.
Finally, because we sure wish you'd have been with us at last Monday night, but you can be tomorrow. And get the family together, bring them all right there. Coliseum, 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. We'll be back in a moment.
Veterans, you remember when mail call was the most important event of the day? Waiting for the next name to be called?
Miller!
Hoping your name would be next. You never missed mail call. And now, as an honorably discharged U.S. veteran, you shouldn't miss out on this important mail call either. Hi, I'm George Kennedy. Thousands of veterans, age 50 to 74, have received a letter like this in their mail that means guaranteed term life insurance for only $1 a week. And all they had to do to get their letter was to call this toll-free number. Every qualified veteran and their spouse or widow, age 50 to 74, is guaranteed acceptance for this low-cost term life plan. Call this number now to find out how much term life insurance you're guaranteed for just $1 a week.
The President's Sale.
Honest Abe Furniture Center has cut prices hundreds of dollars.
By George, you're right. Look at these honest values.
Save over $220 on Toshiba's all-in-one Super Stereo Sound Center, $978. Best swivel rockers, easy, comfy, $30 savings, sale price $147. Choose your color.
By George, Furniture Center can save you hundreds of dollars.
Abe, these are honest values at Furniture Center's President's Sale.
Everybody loves the winner, and fans, this is a winner. The Alliance for Memphis AMC Jeep Renault. Car of the year, 2 years in a row. Run for five, choice of two engines. Front wheel drive, exceptional mileage. The lowest retail price convertible in America today, right here at Memphis AMC Jeep Renault. European technology, but by golly, it's built right here in America, and I like that. So do yourself a favor. Come on out and drive a winner at Memphis AMC Jeep Renault. You deserve it. Bobby, can you get one with a horn that plays Yankee Doodle?
I tell you, a big match was the Mid-America Heavyweight Championship match last Monday night at the Coliseum, and Handsome Jimmy Valiant went in there with a vengeance. I got to say, take a look at the way Jimmy wins this and wins the title. It is only appropriate that he uses that big brace that Iron Mike Sharpe has got. Uses it on Mike. Let's take a look.
Hey, hold my hand up. He now gets the message. And once again, Valiant down on the deck. Count of one, two, and Valiant saves a second pin attempt by slipping that foot over the rope. Handsome fired across the ring into the ropes, and Sharpe missing a big swing with that arm brace. Jimmy nails him. Yeah. from Jimmy. Got a handful of hair on one side. He's got that arm and slams that brace up and nails Sharpe. One, two, three.
There's a one, two, three.
Wait one minute. Did you see that tape? That tape was doctored with. That isn't a legitimate tape. That tape was spiced. It didn't show the real story. Can you imagine a man like Jimmy Valiant being the Mid-America champion? That's a disgrace to professional wrestling. There's no way he could beat a man like me, an athlete like Iron Mike Sharpe. No way. I'll tell you what happened. You want to know the true story? You were there. Do you want to know the true story? I'll tell you the true story. When the referee's back was turned, handsome Jimmy Valiant, the favorite of all the people, the man would never do anything wrong, he took an object, a steel object, out of his trunks and put it in my armband, and then he took this armband and he started knocking me in the head. Sure, I got knocked out temporarily. It could happen to anybody. No man could withstand cold steel on the head. What do you expect?
That's what we've been saying
but
about.
But now there's a gigantic conspiracy to ruin my reputation, Iron Mike's reputation. But I'll tell you something, Hansy Jimmy Valiant. When I get you in the ring, you're going to pay for this. You're going to pay for everything you've done to me. You've ruined my reputation. And you're not going to get away with it. Nobody pulls out an Iron Mike Sharpe. I'll guarantee you that.
Okay, Iron Mike Sharpe having his word to say about handsome Jimmy Valiant. Davey, we're about ready to get right to the ring because this bout coming up, very significant bout indeed, as the Nightmares, Wayne and Dave.
Let me tell you something. This is the big one right here. Okay, if they beat us, we will not come back on this television again. And if we beat them, they gotta take off with or without the mask, right? We talked to Eddie Marlin, and that's what he told us.
It's all come down right here today. We're tired. We're tired of everybody thinking that we're stupid just because everybody else is stupid, because we know, you know, and all the wrestling fans know that Steve Costas and Tim Ashley, those are our masks. So it's all come to a head right here today, baby. If they beat us, just like Ken said, if they beat us, we won't be back at TV. But if we beat them, baby, they take those masks off and they're gone. It's right here today, baby. I'm tired of it. We're not stupid.
I know you guys went to Eddie Marlin and said you wanted to get it settled one way or the other.
Well, that's right. We wanted to get it settled. Let me tell you something. If you beat us, because you couldn't beat us on our worst day, baby. If they beat us, we'll leave the TV and you can do whatever you want. You can stay, take the mask off, keep them on, do whatever you want. But I want the mask back, baby.
Okay, there it is. The Nightmare is going in there. And this, in effect, is kind of a loser leave town. I mean, TV, Dave, because if they pull the mask off, Eddie Marlin has said that they are going to have to go if it's Constant and Ashley and all. We are ready for the action in here as the Nightmares will be going against the Daydreamers. And they have said, bang, that they want to get it settled today.
That's right. The Nightmares claim that is Constant and Ashley under the mask. And Eddie Marlin has said if the only thing they have to do is get the mask off. Eddie?
Clear this up, make sure everybody understands it. If the Daydreamers, they get to take their mask off and stay regardless who they are. If Ken and Danny, then they won't be back on TV.
Right.
But regardless who they are.
If the Nightmares win, then the Daydreamers pull the mask off and they are gone. Is that correct?
But if the Daydreamers win, they get to take them off and regardless who they are, they
okay, Eddie.
All right. Danny Davis in there now against one of the Daydreamers, tag made on Ken Wayne. Wayne and Davis. Wayne using fists. One after another. Danny Davis yelling from up here on the ring apron. Headbutt by Ken Wayne. Tag made and Danny Davis back in there. The former Nightmare. They used to wrestle under the mask. They have claimed that those are their masks that the Daydreamers are wearing, and they think they know who is under those masks. And today, they're going to find out. Wayne and Davis lose it. They're gone from television. Count of two. Danny Davis had a two count on the Daydreamer. Daydreamer fired into the rope. Big clothesline by Ken Wayne as he comes off of there. Wayne and Davis pretty much in control so far. We're coming up on the 2-minute mark. lower part of the leg down across the chin of the Daydreamer. Ken Wayne, right fist. Tag made on Danny Davis. Davis. Got a piece of rope in there. Choking the Daydreamer over in the corner. Referee is being diverted by Ken Wayne, meanwhile. Davis passes the rope out to Ken Wayne out on the apron. See him wrapping it up here. Wayne jumps in, grabs the Daydreamer. Ken Wayne stays in there. Daydreamer back in the corner. Whipped across the ring. Big backdrop. Double backdrop. Danny Davis stays in there.
That's it.
Daydreamer hooks her down, count of one, two. I beg your pardon, that was Danny Davis that had the Daydreamer hooked down. Both of them wearing white. Blocked a bit by Ken Wayne over here. Davis rolls the Daydreamer shoulders down, count as two, and that's the count of two. He breaks out of it again. Wayne and Davis, they said they were going all out. They're doing it. Daydreamer, boy, takes it to the midsection. 3 minutes, 45 seconds gone. 3:45 gone in this one. Wayne gets into the turnbuckles, reverse, round behind. He waistlock and drops into the mat. Count is one, two. Daydreamer kicks him back, rolls him down. One, two. Yay, he got it. The Daydreamers have won the match. Loosening the mask, and it is Constant and Ashley.
The Nightmares are gone from television. They agreed to it. They would not appear on television. They also said if they lost it, they didn't care what the Daydreamers did. And boy, some nifty maneuvering on the end of that match, and a good move by Constant and Ashley as Steve and Tim head on out there delighted. You watch the action as it happens on the end of that match in there when he rolls him up. And boy, I'll tell you, Danny was over here saying, we got him now, we got him now. As he comes out, you see Wayne drive him in. Ken rolls him up, going for the one, two, three. But wait a minute, he fires him in as he pops back out of the corner. He rolls him into a straight 1-2-3 pin, and that is it. No tights, nothing. It's all over with. Nightmares, we won't be seeing around here on television for a while. That's for a living fact. We're going to take time out. We'll be back in a moment.
In a world of millions, the nicest things still happen between just two people.
Oh, Tip! Oh, son of a...
And when you brush your breath with Dentine, being together is nicer for everyone.
You're really here!
Because not even mouthwash can freshen your breath better than when you're chewing lively, long-lasting Dentine.
With the whole wide world for you, now it's down to just you two. Brush your breath.
Honey, listen to this one. Brand new. Now. I need a new stereo. Now.
Hello, Remco.
Call Remco. You can rent to own a brand new Kenwood, Pioneer, or Sansui stereo component system today.
At Remco, I can rent to own a brand new stereo?
Yes, and that's a promise. Remco's affordable rental purchase plan makes it so easy, you won't even need credit.
Hello, Remco.
Hello.
We'll deliver today. We didn't get one or two. We just received an exclusive shipment of 20 brand-new Delta 88s. And at Regal Olds, take your pick. Not for $15,000, but only $11,988. That's all you pay. We guarantee it. And look at all that equipment. All you pay extra is tax and license. But this is important. Many of these Deltas are the last to arrive before the recent GM price increase. You may never find an air-conditioned Delta 88 again for only $11,988. Only while they last. And only at Regal Oldsmobile, downtown in Dealey. Don't miss it.
Aqua Sleep World Superstore Second Store is here at Mendenhall Square next to Chevy's, and you're the one that's going to benefit. Aqua Sleep World is offering fabulous savings, like on the Heritage, probably the finest value at Aqua Sleep World, featuring sculptured shelves, wood frame mirror, and optional decorator footboard. With a 3-foot-tall headboard, the Heritage is a lot of bed for the money, only $2.99. Now, two convenient locations, Summer Avenue and Mendenhall Square next to Chevy's.
Big match between Adrian Street and Randy Savage. They've had a couple of bouts, and in the last particular match in there, I want you to watch what Adrian Street does after he gets Savage tied up in the ropes. Take a look. Randy Savage wide open, swinging away again at him. Look out. And into the ropes. Savage goes with his neck twisted up behind. Oh, boy. Savage is bleeding profusely. And Street continuing to rattle him as he pushes down the referee. That'll get him a fine. Here comes one of the Batten twins. Mark Batten takes a knee in the chin. Here comes Brad. And Street rips him with a right hand. Savage still caught in between.
Adrian Street! Adrian Street!
Eddie Marlin on the microphone. Batten's trying to jump back up in there. Eddie having no success in getting Street's attention.
Don't need him another time. If you do, you'll suspend him. You'll never have him.
And Marlin. Yeah, he told him if he hit him another time, he was suspended, by golly. I've never seen Savage battered around as he was in that, boy. It really was something else. Miss Linda played her part in it, too. He's got Savage in a no-time, no-disqualification match tomorrow afternoon. Hey, we're going to be back to Dave, and he'll tell us what's happening out of town right after we take time out for this.
My dandruff shampoo is good.
Maybe you should try something else. My dandruff shampoo really works.
Maybe you should try something else, like Selsun Blue. Doctors and pharmacists recommend Selsun Blue more than all other leading brands combined. It's number one. What that means to you is no leading brand gets rid of dandruff better than Selsun Blue. Ask your doctor or pharmacist, or try it yourself. That's all the proof you'll need. Selsun Blue. It's number one.
Championship wrestling action coming up all around the Mid-South. Monday night, it's going to be in Jonesboro, Arkansas. There will be six great matches, three title matches. The Fabulous Ones will be returning to Jonesboro. Also, Lawler and Valiant will be there. It's Monday night in Jonesboro, Arkansas. Friday night, the 22nd in Corinth, Mississippi. The Fabulous Ones and the King, Jerry Lawler, all will be there. Friday, March 1st, Blytheville, Arkansas will have championship wrestling. On the same night, Friday, March 1st, championship wrestling in Batesville, Mississippi. Friday, March 8th, in Water Valley, Mississippi. On Saturday, March 9th, in Truman, Arkansas, at the high school. Sunday, the 10th of March, championship wrestling will be returning with a supercard in Jackson, Tennessee. Thursday, the 14th, in Manila, Arkansas. Friday, March 15th, in Union City, Tennessee. On Friday, March 15th, same night, it'll be in New Albany, Mississippi. And on Friday, March 22nd, up in Dresden, Tennessee. That is the championship wrestling action that's coming up around the territory. We urge you to be there when it's in your area. We'll be back with more of it right here in just a moment.
Champion TV and Appliance Rentals makes renting known quick and simple. Just stop by any neighborhood Champion store, and in just minutes, you're on your way with the top products you want. It's quick and simple because there's no credit hassles and on-the-spot approval at Champion. Quick and simple because Champion has over 55 locations. Quick and simple because we make it easy to own when you rent to own television, stereos, appliances, and furniture from Champion TV and Appliance Rentals.
Champion makes it easy to own. Champion.
Here's good news from Performance Toyota. We've got the cars you've been waiting for. Supras, Tercels, Corollas, Celicas, Camrys, and the all-new MR2. We're selling them fast and earning greater allocations every month. Come by today and let us show you our new advanced notice system of exactly what cars and trucks are on the way to Performance Toyota. We've got a Toyota for you at Performance Toyota. Count on us.
Performance Toyota.
Okay. Well, what does everybody want?
Chicken.
Here?
When you want chicken, why go to a place that doesn't specialize in chicken?
You've got a right. Your chicken done right.
At Kentucky Fried Chicken, we do one thing. Chicken with a secret blend of herbs and spices.
You've got a right. Your chicken done right.
Now this is the place for chicken.
Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Dear certs, you'll love this certs encounter. I knew camping wasn't for me, but the hike proved it. Oh well, I thought, I'll just brush off the dust and have a certs. It had to be faked, because out of nowhere came a huge backpack attached to the best-looking guy.
Only certs has a lively, fresh flavor and a glistening drop of Redsen, so it's all you need to freshen your breath and keep it that way.
Well, certs, looks like we're going camping more often.
Certs and sugar-free certs, just in case you're going to be face-to-face.
Okay, we're going to be ready to go with our final match. The Battens are already in the ring, and here, Crow and Rig out here, the Terminators, they're involved in a loser-leave-town match with a couple of rugged guys from San Francisco.
We got a couple losers, all right, to wrestle.
You boys are losers. They're going to be losers tomorrow, day, night, whatever. We're going to beat their faces.
We're going to see what we do today to these guys.
Okay, there have been a lot of guys that have tried it. You guys have got it at stake.
We declare war on everybody, and the Flabs, you too.
Okay. There you have it. We'll find out from that Dirty White Boys Terminators. Davey, let's go to the ring.
Expiration of time match coming up here. There's the referee. You see the Terminators, Crow and Rig, standing in the ring. Their total weight of 472 pounds are out of Minnesota. They're going against at a total of 454 pounds from Charleston, West Virginia. The Batten brothers, Mark and Brad. Match for the expiration of time. Referee is Jerry Calhoun. That is
Mark starting out for them, and right. Rig out for the Terminators.
Uh-huh. Mark and Rig. Tag is made. This is Pro coming in for the Terminators now.
T.H. Hart right along ringside. That's the Jimmy lookalike along with General Eddie Hot Stuff Gilbert. Did we get all the names in?
I think we got them all there. Both of them here at ringside in the Terminators' corner. Crow working on Mark back in the ropes. Mark Batten picked up in the air. Terminator with a body slam. Whoa, he missed. He was going to drop for that upper arm. Tag is made, and here's Brad. Brad in there battling Rig, and meanwhile, Mark is working on Crow over here in the corner. We got all of them in there. With a slide, there's a drop kick. There's a cover by it. Oh, the shoulders were down. All kind of action all over the ring here. All right, the two legal men in the ring now. I'm not sure which two it is. I think it's the one over here on your left.
Hard enough to tell, but when you've got the twins and the Terminators who have a similarity, one of them comes firing out.
It was the ones on the right. So now it's Crow after the tag made by the Terminators. Both Battens have been rolled out of the ring. One of them back up on the apron now. The other one down on the floor. Terminator flips him into the ring.
Our time is just about up here.
Once again, all four of them in the ring. One Batten thrown out. Another one still in the ring, being stalked by Rig, the Terminator. Right. Time is up for the fall. First of all, time has expired. It's going to be a draw. No pin in it. But the action continues. Both Terminators, both the Batten brothers in the ring.
Okay, we got to go to a break, and we'll be back in just a moment. Oh, boy, I'll tell you what. It just keeps going on. We try to get them to stop the referee. They're trying to do it. Davey, we are flat out of time, so what we've got to do is get on out of here. We, in fact, will be back next week. Till then, for Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.
Tough dog.